Starting. Hey, we are live.
Oh, wait, no. I was about to get undressed.
No, you're not. Ew.
Don't. I'm going to get up and be in my underwear.
Well, that's fine. I'll just put the camera on me.
Like you were.
I'm not naked or nothing. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the show.
No, I'm just making fun of you, like, from that one time. Because you claimed that wasn't your underwear.
They're shorts. You ever wear gym shorts, Ian?
No.
Even in gym? You didn't wear gym shorts?
I really didn't take gym. I had swimming.
What? You didn't have gym?
No. My
But they physical... let your ass swim in the water?
Well, yeah, I took a whole year of swimming. That was my physical education credits in high school.
What about middle school?
No.
Uh-huh.
Well, I think we had gym, but I think we just were able to wear, like, you know, like basketball shorts or something, you know?
Fascinating. Okay, basketball shorts. They're shorts, goddammit. I don't do the show in my underwear. Anyway, welcome to the TNT podcast. This is episode 35 already.
Yeah. It is.
It's fucking nuts.
Yep. It's pretty nuts.
As you can tell, if you're tuning in, poor Ian's experiencing technical difficulties still.
Yeah.
He blew his computer up. Now he blew his internet up.
Well, the internet is fine. Obviously, I'm on my router's working fine. As I could tell, all my other devices are good, you know. But my old XP machine isn't. It says the connection is fine, everything. XP? But I think there's something blocking it.
Well, you don't want to be on XP anyway because it's so insecure.
Well, I was trying to get on something like my XP machine. I have 4 gigs in there, so it should be at least able to run in Firefox and shit, you know?
Yeah. I don't know.
I don't think I could put 7 on there because 7 would take up most of it.
Right. Well, I told you they make it's stupid. They make an Android operating system now that's like, supposed to compete with Linux, and I'm like, Android is Linux. So, what?
Yeah.
But whatever. And anyway.
Yeah. A couple other things I was going to try, though, is I was going to try to uninstall my my computer came bundled with an antivirus, which I like used the recovery CD that it came with. It has all the drivers and stuff with it. So I'm going to try to uninstall that, and I think I have to change the date and time. Those are two off or something. They can mess with the internet, I think.
Well, good luck to you, man. That shit sucks.
Yeah. Well, like, I don't know, too. I'm not that well-versed in the networking. Like, I know, like, you could go into like your TCP IP settings or something and mess with that, but I'm not really that good at that type of stuff, you know?
Gotcha.
I mean, you just plug it in and there's something pretty wrong if it's not working, since it's not like you have to set up like a dial up connection or something, you know?
Right. If it's, I mean, on my old Dell or whatever I had that had XP, it had a, always on, you know, Cat5 connection. So, I don't know.
Yeah, the lights on the Ethernet too. You know, like when you on the motherboard.
Speaking of motherboards, while I was trying to go through all my stuff in my inbox for the show, I had an email from Micro Center. You get an Asus motherboard for AM4.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's on sale for $60.
Wow.
So shit.
That's pretty cheap, man.
Right? But you know, I'll wait till Christmas, it'll be cheaper.
Yeah, they're selling a lot of those the adapters with the fans now. You get like a special included, you know. Mm-hmm.
Well, if you already had a cooler that will work with Ryzen, you just have to contact the manufacturer and they'll usually sell you or send you the adapter free of charge. Like if I took my Nachua off of my AM3 CPU and put on an AM4, I just have to contact them and they mail me the brackets that would change it.
They mail it to you for free?
I don't know if I have to pay shipping, but yeah, they said that if you know, it'll work. So, I mean, I'll probably just buy a new one because I don't want to. Eventually, I don't want to change anything out on this machine. So,
yep. My dad helped me fill out. I got, besides getting a pretty good deal on that video card, I got a 30-day rebate. My dad helped me fill out because since I didn't have a computer, we had to go online and shit.
Mm-hmm.
And he had to print it out for me.
How many computers do you have, Ian?
Well, technically, I have, including this free one that I'm trying to mess with, too, is I got four, technically.
Oh, no, you're turning into Doug.
Yeah, but three of them are the older ones, you know?
Hey, it's Benjamin Thompson. Ben?
Ben,
the fuck you want?
Oh, hi, Benjamin.
Hello, Franklin.
It's a fairy princess and Ian show. He's getting tired of this already.
No, I understand you're trying to get your money's worth here.
Well, you know, aren't I pretty?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, boy. Pretty annoying.
Yeah. So how's Ben been doing?
Oh, you know, keeping on.
Well, no, we
never
don't
stop,
know.
Never stopping.
That's why we're asking for the show. What's up?
Not much. Just getting ready to eat some food. Thought I'd come and say hi.
I'm hungry. You gonna feed me too?
Hi, hungry. I'm Dad.
You're not my dad.
You don't know that.
I'm quite sure. But your dad's name is Frank, and my name is Frank, so...
You still look drunk, so...
Well, I can't
drunk
help
fairy it. Fairy princess.
It maps my face to what I actually look like, so...
So you're saying you're drunk, okay.
I'm just buzzed. So... Anyway,
how's the show going?
Oh,
it just started.
Yeah, it's just sailing right along, Ben.
Cool.
Yeah, the Drunken Elf and Ian show.
Hmm.
What are you eating there, Ben?
Hash brown.
Ooh, that sounds good. I had yesterday was usually Taco Bell night for me, but. We broke from tradition and had smoky bones.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Had fried pickles and a buffalo chicken sandwich. Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yummy. Shit, what are you guys going to eat tomorrow?
I don't know.
The Easter Bunny when you kill him.
Yeah, I had cereal today, so, I mean, you know. I don't know. I fly by the seat of my pants or skirt or whatever.
Aren't you going over to see Ben there?
No.
No.
No. We don't see each other that often. Saw his ass last week.
So that was kind of like a pre-Easter kind of thing, huh?
Well, yeah. We got together with everybody. And, yeah.
Okay.
But Anyway, there. So now that everyone's caught up on what's been going on, Ian's got computer issues. I'm a little girl in the woods.
In the woods. So
yeah, but I've been. Can I show you some stuff I've been working on?
Oh yeah, sure.
Yeah, working on more of these
LEDs.
LED adapters here.
What you know?
No. So what's been these going, are all finished. Did you get what's been going on with your power supply and stuff, Ian? Yeah.
That stuff is okay. It's. I'm sure I'm going to be able to get it to work. It's just in the meantime, I was trying to get it, like an old computer to work. But like I was telling Frank in the audience, I was trying to get on an old XP machine, which has like I have 4 gigs of RAM in there, which should be enough to run Firefox, I would think. But I can't get on the internet on the thing for some reason because, what. Like the connect, it says it's connected on the LAN or whatever on my computer, but like when I go into the Internet Explorer or whatever to download Firefox, I can't even get to a web page for some reason. So I'm trying to diagnose that shit.
What error does it give you, or if any?
It just says the page can't be displayed. You know. Yeah. So something's blocking the internet or some shit.
Check with your network admin.
Yeah.
You probably got you might have a router issues, or it might be like what's that word? What's that word for when it blocks one of the ports? I don't know.
Firewall or
yeah, firewall.
I had the thing is the firewall is totally disabled.
Yeah. Well, on my when I first my old motherboard I had it hooked up to Ethernet, and I had to go download the drivers on another computer for my Ethernet. The Ethernet drivers weren't working for whatever reason. So, like, my network drivers were shit. So I had to go with a flash drive to another computer, download them, put them on that drive, walk over here, plug them in, unzip it, and install them. And then after that, it worked fine. My new motherboard was fine. I never had to do any of that shit. Anyway.
Yeah. Also, I was working on this this DC to Molex adapter I'm going to make. All I got to do is solder the two wires together.
Oh, boy.
Put some heat shrink. But, yeah. You're saying Molex is the devil, isn't it, Frank?
Well, I mean, have you ever seen that? I think I linked you that video of, was it Mark Furman or whatever his name is? That network guy who does a lot of IT stuff. And he had a Molex adapter for one of his drives that he didn't even like look at. He said, I've had it for almost 10 years. It's got to be good. And then he went out of town and it fucking caught on fire in his computer.
Shit, man.
Yeah, so, but he had a microscope, and a USB microscope, and showed us. He's like, this is why it failed. Look for this when you're buying them. I was like, huh.
Yeah.
Cheap Chinese shit.
Well, I would make a I could make a DC to the SATA power thing, but I would need a in order for it to work with my LED things, I would need to find a female one of those plugs, you know, like
female,
you know how it's a female on like your SSD or your hard drive or whatever. I need to find like an end that's the female, not just the male, so the male part can plug in from the PSU to that.
He's always trying to plug it in.
Plug it in.
Well, do you think at some point you're just going to end up saying fuck it and buying like a prefab thing to stick in there, or you like tinkering too much?
Well, I mean, I like tinkering, and you know, like those things are like really expensive because they usually don't just have like the adapter for it. Usually you have to buy the whole, like pay $20 just for like a 1 foot LED strip, you know?
I don't know how
that's just made for the inside of your computer.
Right. I've only bought one, LED strip yet for anything. So
yeah. But
But oh, speaking of LEDs on our battle stations thing, I've got a little LED thing on one of the setups to talk about. So.
All right.
Well, I emailed you three of them. Are we do? I figured we would we switch off, like I said before. Like, who brings the battle stations each week?
Right. Well, I just had a little thing to show you. I really thought it was interesting. So I figured it'd be relevant to your interests.
Gotcha.
My one news story I have is another relevant to your entrance story. So
cool.
Relevant to your entrance?
Yeah, that's what I said.
You didn't have anything else going on, Ben, though?
I've been trying to catch up on sleep. I had a bloating the other day. That's a bitch.
Bloating?
Yeah, you ever have that, Frank?
Well, like,
from you eating? Went to Mexican, and then that night I woke up, my stomach was like, hey, guess what? Oh, ow. No, it wasn't. That was the problem. I mean, if it was doing that, it would be great. Instead, it was the, hey, you're going to inflate up like a balloon, and your back's going to hurt, and you're not going to be able to sleep, and everything is going to hurt.
Well, did you take some Tums or anything?
Yeah, I took some stuff for it, but the fact that I wasn't able to sleep on it was, yeah.
Well,
it's like you lay down, and it's like, ah.
You should have took Beano before, and there'll be no gas.
No. No, no, no.
If Frank's laughing because he's like, he just relieved himself before the show yet, so he's pretty good.
Yeah,
well, he's like, hey, that's the thing. That's the thing, guys. It's like, gas is one of those things we all laugh like, haha, farts, lol. It's like, no, man, that shit's some serious business when you can't, when it's like in the middle of the night and you feel like, like, you know that frog in the first Shrek movie where they blow him up like a balloon and just carry him around? Or like one of those squeeze toys where you squeeze it and the eyes bug out? That's what you feel like. You're just like, all you can think is like, let this end, please.
Right.
Well, oh, man.
He was like, are we doing the show? And I was like, it'll be a minute. He's like, oh, what's the matter? I'm like, I gotta take a shit.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for not, you know, being, I mean, you have your face cam on. We could have just assumed you were dead-eyed the whole time. And then we hear, flush.
Yeah.
How do we know you're not using the crapper now, Frank? Hey, how do we know you ever left the bathroom?
The leopard cheetah girl's shit in the woods?
Well, I don't know. Why don't you tell us, leopard cheetah girl?
You'll never know. I don't get to tell you shit. So.
Yeah, I had major heartburn when I was watching the dogs, man. That shit was crazy.
Right.
So did you also, did I tell you... Did I tell you Saturday after I talked to you, Frank, my parents' basement flooded while I was there?
No. Hmm. Didn't that happen last time?
No.
Well, they say that happened.
They had it.
Like, how bad was it? Was it just like the carpet got soaked, or was it like ankle deep?
No, it wasn't ankle deep. It was like it rained in there. There was like a lot of puddles and stuff.
They don't got a sump pump?
They do have a sump pump, and but it was going bad.
Oh.
Yeah, so they had to call a plumber out to get it fixed.
My dad and father-in-law were out in another part of Ohio and at a gun show, and my mother-in-law called and said, the downstairs bathroom's backed up, and there's shit all come out. They said, gotta go!
Yeah, Dad said Dad's sub pump failed on him once, and he had to go and, drain it and get fixed. Remember that, Frank?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I was working like 8 hours, taking up wet boxes up and down the state, or just up and outside in the garage, and I had to like carry like 100-pound wet rug up there.
Ugh.
And I had to use a too. What?
I said that rug really tied the room together too.
Yeah.
It's a Lebowski.
I had to shop that back out the whole basement too. It was a mess, man.
Oh, hey, Ian. Have you seen Pulp Fiction yet?
No, I haven't.
What the fuck is wrong with you? I was gonna make a theme song with that, like my Ghostbusters, but I got lazy.
Yeah, we kind of figured, Frank.
Hey Ben, have you seen the new MST3K?
I have not had time to sit down and enjoy it uninterrupted, so not yet.
I sat down and watched two episodes of it today.
Two episodes? You said you were binge watching it. That doesn't really qualify for binge watching, I don't think.
It's a really long show because it's a movie each episode. And then I had to go mow the grass. So, but anyway, did you want to do the news or the setup thingies first?
Do they do Star Crash on that? Because I saw a frame of it and I said, oh,
I don't know. I don't know. Ian?
Okay, what do you want to do? Do you want to do the battle stations first?
Sure. Those are always fun.
Yeah.
Those are fun for everyone. Just let me move my thing to the screen that's not going to piss everybody off.
It's fun for a boy and a girl.
Uh-huh. And... one second here. Okay, here we go. Okay. So this was
all right.
First setup.
Yeah.
With the nice little pink keyboard there.
Yeah.
I almost wrote that pink. Same tower that this guy's got here. That N
really
EXT or whatever. You know what that is?
The NZXT.
Yeah, isn't that what that is?
Yeah.
I almost went with that. When I built my first computer. And then I didn't. But, yeah, he's using a sound bar. He's got M50X headphones.
Yeah. Yeah, he does have a list on there. That's good.
Yeah, he's got a Hue Plus LED thing.
Generic external volume control from Amazon.
IKEA.
Got figurines in his case.
Yeah, a lot of guys are doing that, and some people are like, I can't believe you do that. That's got to be bad for airflow. And I'm like, okay, they did videos where they stuffed a fucking t-shirt in a computer and the airflow was fine, so little Gundam I think are going to be all right.
I mean, like, what are they running? Are they running solid states and stuff? It's like, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, there's at least one right there.
I was saying, there's probably not that much heat anymore.
Yeah.
And it's liquid cooled. Got a radian. What is that, a 480? Yeah, it's a 480.
Yeah. Are those, like, custom? My concern
would be if it melted the figurines or something, because...
Yeah.
What do you?
Are those custom, keyboard, keys or whatever?
Keycaps. Yeah, they're keycaps. Yeah, it's a Red Dragon keyboard with white keycaps. So apparently
that's white. Apparently
they're backlit red, is my guess. Because if you look at the white space bar, there's red right in the middle.
Yeah,
so
I see.
Yeah, I don't know why some of them are black, but it would appear as such.
Now that I look at it closely, I don't know if I like the keyboard. or like that stop. You know, that combination with the keyboard.
Uh-huh.
That's my only gripe, I guess.
Yeah, I think it's cool. I would have made it appear a little more wireless, but, you know, if you got the smaller keyboards, a lot of guys will... They just run the wire. They don't give a shit.
And he's got like the world on the wall.
Yeah, I was going to say, I like how he's got the world where it's like he's like a evil villain or something.
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to. Hold on, got to reboot. Okay. Task match? Nope.
Right. Now, then you got this guy here who uses the entire surface area.
Yeah.
That looks a little more cluttered.
That's like
he uses the whole surface area.
Something Nate would have.
He's got the whole surface area, but then he has like one figurine in each cubby.
Yeah, he's got Gundams and trophies. I remember on when I saw this post, they're like, "Are those tennis trophies or whatever?" And he's like, "Yeah." High school got like two or three pairs of headphones.
Really like spun them though.
Yeah, he's put a bunch of them together. Got two chairs, so I guess it's a. I don't know. It's a corner of the fucking room. It really, you need to go back and see more. Is what it is.
Yeah.
It just looks a little cramped, is what it is.
Yeah, I mean, it's a pretty big desk for what it is, though. I mean, it's bigger than what I got. But, and this guy, he's got, was it Xbox? A little tiny monitor.
It's a baby monitor.
Next to a bigger monitor.
That's like a TV on the right one, isn't it?
Yeah. That's his TV for his X-Bone or PS1 or what, or PS4 or whatever the fuck he's got going on.
Or that'd be a really expensive monitor.
Yeah. Well, some guys rock that because, you know, apparently you can get like a 40-something inch 4K TV for like $300 now.
So, yeah. Well, the things that I think that there's some TVs with, isn't it like the Hertz or something like that?
Yeah, some guys, yeah, they, you know, oh, it's got to be 144 or whatever, and some say, fuck it. I'm in the fuck it category myself.
Yeah.
I'm not rocking a TV for my main display. I've got, you know, an actual monitor with V-Sync, but I don't know.
This guy's into some kind of anime or something.
Yeah, he's got I don't remember what this one's called. With the little girl with the monster. I feel bad that I don't know the name of that one. I'm aware of it.
My Neighbor Totoro, Frank.
Yeah, I'm aware of it and I've seen it. I just don't. I've never watched it myself. I have a backlog of so many that I need to see. But I don't.
No, he's got a snowball.
Blue snowball microphone.
If you're trying to show off your rig, I don't think that's necessarily like a mic that you would like want to show off that much. You know,
I mean they're blue mics, so they're still good. It's not like, you know, a cheapy little $5 microphone you got at Staples or something. It's still decent. You know,
yeah.
Some guys even put them on arms and stuff, so they're, you know, they're decent.
Well, I guess now that I think about it, it would be nicer, like a mic on like an arm or whatever, because like I don't know, like mics just sitting on your desk, I don't think look as good to me.
Yeah, I mean, if you got the room for it. What I'm confused about is why he's got like 8 controllers here.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, it's like let's all squeeze in here and.
Right.
Play on his TV here.
Okay, so it is a PS4. I can never tell just by looking at the fucking things if they're a PS4 or an X-Bone. The controllers were making me think it was a PS4. Looks like.
Yeah, my friend just got a PS4 Pro or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what the difference is, but I'm sure Doug would be able to say because he's the Sony pony, you know?
Don't get him started. I think I think the back ones are Xbox controllers and the front ones are the PlayStation ones. So I think he has both, it looks like.
Right.
But, you know, you got to show off. I mean, it's obviously a PlayStation now that I look at it because on the screen, there's the triangle, the X, and the, you know, but I couldn't see that without maximizing it. Plus, I don't have my glasses on. I'm an old man. But, yeah, he's got the wall scrolls looking good. He's got his interests there. I got the same Venetian blinds on my one window, and they're tore to shit. I need to replace them. So he went up me there at least.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I would probably go with the TV one first, then the Gundam, then the other one would be the last one, you know, for me.
So you'd like this?
That.
That's your second or first?
Now this would be my least favorite one. The one with the Gundams is the second, and then the one with the giant TV in it would probably be my first.
See, I like this one because it's laid out, it's simple, there's still room, it doesn't feel cramped. This one, although he shows his own interest, he's got his Gundams everywhere, it feels like he's cramming, shoehorning shit into a corner of a room that he doesn't have room for. And then this one, I mean, has good stuff, but there's, you know,
it's also cramped.
I mean, he's got a rocking keyboard, because I think that's the same one I have. But it's, he's got the Razer mouse that looks like the Naga.
Yeah.
Which is similar.
I think it's because of that 90 degree, you know, corner we're looking at is what makes it feel so cramped. If that were, like, on a table like the first one, then it would probably feel less
I mean, he's got two things set up so he can do one or the other. It just feels like, instead of being able to go, okay, let me look at the other side of the room where my TV's at, the TV's right the hell there. And, you know, you feel a little like he's over top of himself. The first one, you know, it feels like he's got more room, leg room. I mean, he might not. It might not be that big of a room, but the way he's presenting it, you know. So.
Right, right.
I mean, the triple monitors would probably look better if he had, like, a stand than a, you know, a mount or something, like an arm. So he'd have a little room under them so he could still use the desk. But, you know, he's doing better than I am.
So which one would you be your second place on this one for you?
I think my first goes to this.
Okay.
And then probably this one for second, just because there's, even though it's kind of cramped, there's shelf space. If I had all those shelves, I'd put all kinds of crap on them. I actually want shelves, but, you know, that's a whole different.
Well, the difference between the second and the third one is, like, the second one, he just crops it down to just the system, versus the other guy, he shows you his shelves that he's got, but then the system looks tiny in comparison to it.
Yeah.
Okay, what about you, Ben?
I'd probably go in the order that they're taken. I mean,
so you'd go wood desk, Gundam, and PS4?
Yeah, because the thing is, you know, that last one, a corner desk is very cramped, especially when you got something right next to you. So, it's like, I think the other one, even though it's still more spread out than that one, it's just, you know, I'm not crazy about Gundam. But I do like that big TV in the third one.
Gundam.
Yeah.
Well, you know.
I guess I'm kind of partial to corner desk myself, probably.
Well, I mean, you have a big-ass TV for one of your monitors, don't you? So.
Yeah.
So I figured it would apply to your taste. Now,
right.
The ones I had, I'm not really wanting us to critique and vote. I just wanted to show you some that I wouldn't, you know, think of. You probably have seen these fucking things before. These big ass what do they call those, nano leaf tiles that are starting to become popular.
Huh. I've never seen those before. They look cool though.
Yeah, they're just like, they have a little plug to them. They just plug into the wall and they're, you know, lights that light up RGB, and you put them, you clip them together and make a, you know, I've seen videos on them, and you make a pattern of whatever you want. And but the thing is, those are $200.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, I mean, granted, they're new and they're something to get people talking, but so I was like, oh, that's, you know, that's cool, that's something different. A lot of people are like, do you like them? Are they all they're cracked up to be? Like, I think Random Frank P did a review, and he was saying they're $200. He's like, I think it's a little overpriced for what you get. Then I just happened to be looking at battlestations, and I find this cat. It's got a nicely, you know, nicely put together setup. You know, a little, what is that, a bungee back chair so it can breathe.
Yeah.
He's got one ultra monitor, which, you know, that's, if you're going to go one monitor out, I advise that. That's totally awesome. And then if you look up behind his monitor there, I was like, what the fuck are those? And I can't find the original post. I just found the imager link. those are pieces of paper with styrofoam in the back, and then an LED strip around the styrofoam, just to add some.
Oh, okay.
Just to add some depth and dimension. I think he had other pictures, cool. Like, because people are like, "What are those?" So he posted like a actual album of just setting those up.
Right.
And it's not, you know, yeah. See, here's up close. You can see the LED strip.
Yeah.
You know, it's nothing crazy, but you know as well as I do, an LED strip will cost you next to nothing. Styrofoam, right. He probably had in a box of parts that he was going to throw away, so he said, let me cut out a shape, and this is just literally...
So you can get that shit at the dollar store.
So what you're saying, Frank, is he Martha Stewarted that bitch, and it looks nice.
Yeah, he took a couple...
Yeah.
Just like cable management, you do a couple minutes of next to nothing cost work, and you think about it, and you make it look like he's got his shit in the corner too. But like, look, he's got a little separate stand for his tower. He's got his lights on, you know, one on the dresser and one on the tower, so you can't even, you know, it doesn't stand out, but it looks nice.
Yeah, you could do that shit with hot glue with LEDs and the styrofoam.
Yeah, that's, I mean, or if you got good enough, you know, LEDs that come with the, you know, sticky on the back.
Well, most of them do, but the problem is this sticky back isn't that good, so
I mean,
usually you have to get better double-sided tape for it or hot glue.
Or, you know, whatever. whatever's laying around. I mean, the guy, you know, MacGyvered this shit, but it looks pretty pimp, I think. He did it to where you go, oh, what's that? I don't see that all the time. It's something different, and it probably cost him the cost of paper and a you know, LED strip.
That's what are the kids calling it nowadays? Clutch.
What?
That's so clutch or whatever.
Quit trying to make fetch happen.
guys,
I like this setup, and I like what he was able to do with, you know, I don't know any of the other specs on anything. I don't know anything else. But I saw that, I said, that's cool. So I thought, you know, I'd share that.
Or you could say, that's so lit.
No, I wouldn't say that. But, anyway.
Word up,
So, anyway.
Yeah, so I guess the winner would be the first one then.
Yeah.
And the second one.
The guy with the wood table, Ben and I versus you, so two against one there.
Yeah.
And then the rest is kind of divided, right?
Sure.
Yeah, well, I was the only one that chose that one. First of all, both of you guys were pretty much the same on the order of the other ones.
Well, I like having, you know, I've got my computer on this side, and I've got my drawing set up on that side. So it's like, when it's right next to you, I had my computer in the TV room in the other room for a while, and... When something's right up next to you, my knee started hurting, and it's like, I gotta keep turning back, and I look like I don't know. It's a little snug, is what I'm saying. I like it to feel open.
Is that animation table collecting dust? Hmm? Have you even used that?
Hmm? I've got a lot of stuff in here, Ian. I got more stuff than I got space.
More stuff that he's got brains, too.
What's that, Frank? You don't want me to come back on the show? I guess I can get going then.
I'm a little fairy princess in the woods. Don't be mad at me.
What's a fairy princess in the woods doing looking at freaking battle stations and stuff, man? Come on now.
They can dream too, goddammit. Why you gotta harsh on their interests? Alright. Well, are we ready for the news yet?
Yep. Oh, by the way, what's the username of the first one? Was there... If you could give a shout out to him, we should probably do that.
Oh, hold on.
As you won, congratulations.
Username.
A show of a handful of listeners is giving you a shout out. So.
Well, he's got the world, so he doesn't need.
Right, he's got the world. He's got a cool station.
But the world is not enough.
I don't think his username's on his imager, is it?
I don't know.
We apologize. We will correct this action in the future.
Yeah.
But I try to link straight from Reddit so you can see others' comments. But when I email myself, it just emails the imager link, which, you know, Take or leave it. Sorry, guy. Well, I don't know your name. I'll find it.
Well, if you go, it was one of the newer ones on the battle station, so.
Oh, was it?
Whatever the user is on there.
Well, then. Battle stations. I found like five in a row that had the exact same desk.
It was kind of cool. Yeah.
But,
probably like it's kind of IKEA desk or something.
Oh, yeah. It was. Oh, don't get me wrong. It's the desk I'm getting, but. Where the hell is it? I know I saw that. There it is. Whoop. About 90% done. God damn it. No, I don't want the imager.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to find a Reddit link, but it was.
His username is Count Monte Cristo.
Okay.
That's his Reddit name.
Cool.
So, if you happen to listen, I mean, you already got 343 upvotes, dog, so you got more than, yeah. You know, my setup's going to probably get, but. Yo, dog.
Yeah, this small time podcast is showing you giving you a shout out though. So whatever that's worth.
Creator station. I went into the thing to make a live thing, and it was like, oh, by the way, you're also, you know, have monetization enabled. Oh, but you can't get any paid stuff until you get a month. You know, 1,000 whatever. Like, oh yeah.
Yeah, that's what we talked about then.
We weren't sure if it was going to be retroactive against us because we were partners before that whole thing happened.
Right.
So now we know.
Yeah.
No moolah for us.
Knowing it's half the battle.
G.I. Joe. Okay. I've got one new story that I want to share.
Because you only have one?
Yeah. I had two, but you covered the other one. So.
Right.
I figured this one's I wanted to share because I figured Ian would dig it.
Okay, let's do it.
As long as we're talking about computers real quick, do you guys hear they're supposed to be redoing the Mac Pro in 2018?
Oh, really? I was wondering what is going on with the... Is that... There hasn't been, like, an update for a while.
Yeah, and people are like, the trash can? It's pretty much like that cube that they did. Remember that thing?
Oh, yeah. Did you see that video I sent you, Ben, of Snazzy Labs?
Maybe, but I can't remember it.
He built a Hackintosh in a tribute.
Oh, the quiet one, yeah.
It's Ian probably wouldn't dig it because it's a Hackintosh, so it runs Mac OS, but it's silent. He was literally running the onboard graphics, which unless you're doing, you know, graphic work, who cares? So, but it was, you know, Intel with a. It had an aluminum case. So the case acted as a heat sink. So there were no fans in it at all.
Nice.
It's different. But he said the most expensive part of the bill was the fucking case and the power supply. He said that ended up being over like $400 right there. But yes. But it's silent because there's no fans. So that's cool. But anyway.
For my my other computers, that's supposed to be just for rendering. I wonder if they're gonna do any Ryzen the APUs like they had the Trinity ones.
Oh yeah,
because those would be good. So,
well, I got our one semi listener, Stupid Floyd, who's an Xbox fanboy, was pointing out how Scorpio is gonna have an AMD APU, and I'm like. It's not meant to compete with a computer, and even if it is, it'll only compete for like a year max before something new comes out.
Well, I mean, my concern right now is, you know, I've got this computer which it can't run Sierra, so it's effectively got like, what, 2 years left in it? So I'm trying to figure out what my next rig is going to be, and it's like, I don't know, I could go for a mobile solution, but I'd kind of like to see whatever I get as an investment into... you know, years in the studio, and mobile just does not last as long as this, you know, I planned for this thing to last 10 years, and it's on 8, so I'm, you know.
Well, what?
Well, no, it's on 9 now, think about it.
What's the limitation of it? Because, I mean, I thought the Mac Pros have really good hardware in it, so I don't know, like, why wouldn't it be compatible? Like, how much RAM does it require you to have?
No, it's just, I don't know what it is, but, like, they had the cutoff limit is, like, you know, when I went to install it, it said, not supported on this hardware or whatever, you
it's
know, on this
built-in
version.
Obsolescence is what it is, Ian. Yeah. Just like you can, you know, if you have a new, CPU, you can't put fucking Windows 7 on it.
Yeah, is that's what they're trying to do with the new Ryzen things, right? And the new Intel.
Yeah. They're like, no,
that's really messed up, dude.
Well, I mean, to be fair, guys, I got this thing in 08. You know, that'd be like expecting, you know, an XP machine to run Windows 7 or 8, you know?
Right.
It's like, eh. It's like, you don't expect to get 10.
I mean, you know, whatever. But,
It just sucks because they're like, this is the only operating system you could get with this hardware.
Well, I mean, you can put, you know, Windows on it with Boot Camp or whatever, or Linux, but I like what I got.
Yeah, if you really, you know, if you want to put together something, if you really are, you know, set on Apple, you could do a Hackintosh for reasonable, so, or better than what they're offering.
I don't know. That's why I'm waiting to see what they roll out within, you know, within the next 2 years. So if I want to go with their next option, or if I want to build something, or if I just want to go for like the, you know, the Mobile Studio Pro or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
So here's my story that I figured Ian would really have a boner for. New 3D printing method creates shape shifting objects.
Oh no! Oh, it's nice. A transformer.
We have a transformer. Yeah. A new 3D printing method has been developed to create objects that can permanently transform into a range of different shapes in response to heat. A lattice created by a multi-material 3D printer at Georgia Institute of Technology that can permanently expand to 8 times its original width after exposure to heat. A team of researchers from Georgia Institute of Technology and 2 other institutions has developed a new 3D printing method to create objects that could permanently transform into a range of different shapes. The team, which included researchers from Singapore University of Technology and Design and Chiang Jiatong University in China, created the objects by printing layers of shape memory polymers, with each layer designed to respond differently when exposed to heat. This new approach significantly simplifies and increases the potential of 4D printing by incorporating the mechanical programming post-processing step directly into the 3D printing process, said Jerry Key, a professor in the George W. Woodruff School of Mechanical Engineering at Georgia Tech. This allows high-resolution 3D printed components to be designed by computer simulation, 3D printed, and then directly and rapidly transformed into new permanent configurations by simply heating.
I've heard about something similar, actually, like a long time ago, where I think they were able to use water or whatever to change it, and they used the same term before the 4D printing. But, like, I don't know. I'm not sure, like, what you would be able to apply this to, you know, like, just because you can make something puff up or whatever, you know, like, maybe that could be good in the medical field or something. I don't know.
Don't
ease some kind of
those little dinosaur
trauma.
Put in water and they turn into a sponge.
Well, that's true.
So, who knows?
We could bring those back.
Hey, this will make something that, you know, it has potential. It's just what to see the applications for in the future will be interesting.
What's that? What are those devices that they use to help, like, alleviate things, like, for in the medical field where they got to puff up things or something? I don't know. They can put that kind of stuff in your body to help shit, you know?
What, like bleeding? Or
yeah.
Seepage?
Something, I don't know.
Benjamin?
What now? What are we talking about?
Bleeding and seepage.
I mean, I don't know too much about 3D printing, but it looks pretty cool to be able to build stuff that moves. I don't
Move?
know.
Yeah.
But
Yeah.
it doesn't move as much as like get bigger or whatever,
Well,
depending on the temperature.
I mean, we're only changing atoms and electrons, and it's like there's only so much. I mean, remember back in the day when the thing was like, this thing gets hot and it changes color, and it's like, oh, shrieky dinks, they get smaller when they get hot. It's like, it's all about, tech doing little things, and 30 years from now, something cool is gonna happen with this.
Yeah, Shrinky Dinks is now pretty much shit that's available on Etsy.
Yeah, custom shrieky dinks.
Yeah. Okay.
All those Etsy stores.
Right. Okay. Ready for our next story, guys?
Yeah, is this one of mine then?
Yeah. Yep. On.
Okay.
Tabs could be coming out, not only to explore, but everywhere. Ha, tab sugar-free. Many have called for
Okay.
Explorer to be tabbed. People fucking use Explorer? That's I don't buy that for a second.
It's not Internet Explorer.
Oh. Not like an
Okay,
Explorer
let me.
window?
Yeah, just like
They
within your
are.
file system.
Aren't they already? I mean, you can
Let me
open up
just read
the
it.
window.
Citing sources familiar with the matter, Windows Central is reporting that Microsoft could be bringing a tabbed interface to Windows 10 apps. There have been, or there have long been calls for Explorer to support tabs so that multiple locations on the file system can be browsed without a proliferation of windows. But the report says that Microsoft may be going a step further, bringing tabs to just about every window. The feature is apparently called Tabs Shell. It would allow any application with multiple windows to have those windows collapse into one another by creating a tab bar. Conversely, tabs can be turned off the tab bar to create separate windows, providing an appearance and experience that mirrors that of the Edge browser. With this, Microsoft could neatly meet the demand for tabs and Explorer and similar requests to have tabs for the command line. Yeah.
Well, I'm saying I'm not nothing against Microsoft here, but with Apple you can with their Finder windows you open it and it makes a tab. It's and it works great. I kind of actually do wish this was Windows, so.
Well, actually, in Windows 7, I've been using that QT tab bar, which does the same thing, and it offers other features and shit. You should look into it.
I'll just open another window and close it later. I don't care.
But
Benjamin?
it's cool because it gives you like you could put custom icons and stuff on your window, so like you could change the view or whatever of it, or open an application.
Yeah, I'm all about customizing.
Yeah, it's another tinkering thing.
Tinker, tinker, tinker.
But You're a little tinker.
take, take, take.
I guess it
Yeah.
would be cool, like if you have, like if there's apps that use like multiple windows, like can't really think of an example right now, but I don't know. If there's a program that doesn't have tabs that, but it opens up a whole bunch of different instances of it, it can just keep them all in this one window, I guess. So it's all about what how many instances the program uses. Most of the time it's just one instance, but yeah,
It
I
would
don't know
change
what.
things. It would clutter free up your desk a little bit. You wouldn't have
Yeah.
so many things taking up space. It'd all be in one window that you could view.
I do wonder, like, would that keep you would you still have like separate EXEs in your process manager or whatever showing then, but it would just be in one window?
Maybe. I'd have to. That'd be interesting. You'd have to look at Task Manager and see how giant it is. Yeah. Whenever I open Task Manager, is fucking retarded.
Oh yeah.
Yes. Well, I live that Google life, and Chrome like eats up resources like a bitch.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
True. True.
Like, I have a custom. Since I changed the dark theme on the Windows 7, I also installed a custom shell for the process or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
The task manager.
Mm.
So it changed the look of that too.
Gotcha.
It's good to use a third party manager too, because sometimes like if you get a bad virus and the virus disables your task manager, mm-hmm. it's good to have a third party one. Like I like to use Process Explorer. Hmm. It gives you like really crazy views of it and like your networking and hard drive resource usage and stuff, you know.
But
what do you think about that, Ben?
Tabs and so we're talking tabs in what kind of applications? Window. What?
Like Explorer, like your Explorer window, like on a Mac when your Finder window. If you
yeah, I know, I know the Finder has tabs. I only discovered that a while back, and it's like yeah, that's good. I'd rather have one window with all the stuff on it than a whole bunch of different windows you got to track down and wrangle.
Right. Yeah.
But wrangle.
And then it was also saying there was an API to be able to do that for all your instances of each program. So each program, like if you have like 50 Firefox tabs or whatever, it would just keep them all in the same tab. I guess.
I don't know. I don't know.
Frank's like, this sounds like black magic to me.
I don't know, man. If you've ever seen, like, you know, as Frank was saying with Chrome, man, it's like, you know, you open that up on a Mac and look at your system thing, and it's like, you know, a whole row of just Windows Chrome processors just eating up space. It's like, oh, man.
Well,
yeah.
Let me see. How many do I... Oh, okay. Hold on. Show you my task manager. Look down here at the bottom. Chrome. So yeah.
Those are all open windows you have?
No. I only have two Chrome browsers open.
That's weird.
Well, three if you count the Hangout.
Well, after the Hangouts, I would say I would kill all of those and just open up a fresh one then.
Yeah. Well, I only usually have one window open. I'm looking. There's actually. I know for Firefox, there's what's it called? What the fuck is that thing called? There's a extension or a plugin that lets you divide up your screen within like your how in Windows you can have two apps running side by side, take up your screen. You can do that with your browser, so you can have multiple web pages open within one instance. And I want to see if there's one like that for Chrome, because with an ultra wide, I have the room to have multiple web pages open without actually having to have the browser shrunk down to, you know, take up different instances. But anyway.
Right.
Back to the story here.
Oh, that's right. Cool. I guess moving on, we should get to the second story about... Okay, so this is about why one Republican voted to kill privacy rules. Nobody has to use the internet.
Yeah, quote, this unquote. Is a story I had. I was like, are you fucking kidding me, guy? And my wife hates it when I call people guy, too, by the way.
Well, to be fair, Frank, you know, we do have a vice president who won't be alone in a room alone with women or dance because something.
<That's> stupid.
So.
Okay.
Okay.
You want to read this one or?
Yeah, that's fine. A Republican lawmaker who voted to eliminate internet privacy rules said, quote unquote, nobody's got to use the internet, when asked why ISPs should be able to use and share their consumers or customers' web browsing history for advertising purposes. U.S. Representative Jim Sensenbrenner
Republican from Wisconsin.
was hosting a town hall meeting when a constituent asked about the decision to eliminate privacy rules. A person in the audience was disputing the Republican argument that ISPs should face stricter requirements than websites such as Facebook. Say, quote unquote, Facebook is not comparable to an ISP. I do not have to go on Facebook, the town hall meeting attendee said. But when it comes to internet service providers, the person said, I have one choice. I don't have to go to Google. My ISP is provider is different than those providers. That's when Sensenbrenner said, nobody's got to use the internet. He praised ISPs for investing an awful lot of money in having almost universal service now. He then said, I don't think it's my job to tell you that you cannot get advertising for your information being sold. My job, I think, is to tell you that you have the opportunity to do it, and then you take it upon yourself to make the choice, quote unquote. People ought to have more choices rather than fewer choices with the government controlling our everyday lives, he concluded before moving on to the next question. He said that nobody has to use the internet, they have a choice. Sensenbrenner's press office explained on Twitter. Well,
I don't know what technology is.
I
Why are you
like how
asking?
he takes it and goes, "Don't let the government get into your business. Let all these corporations that were selling all your private information, let them run your lives."
Well,
I
it's like
just.
we went backwards. We had a cool hip president who actually had a laptop in the Oval Office and was getting shit done. And now we have some assholes who don't know what the fuck a computer is and why they have to use sanctioned devices that can't be hacked. Oh, fucking hell.
Right. Well, I guess he's, to be the devil's advocate, I guess he's trying to say that it's this the internet is just a like a luxury, it's not like a need for your life or
Well,
whatever.
that's the thing. Like that was the argument with the FCC and making, with telephone services and saying that they couldn't, be a monopoly, that they couldn't, install fast lane and all that stuff because, well, telephones are needed. And, they're saying in the 21st century, realistically, you need to have the internet. If there's a lot of places you want to get employed, they tell you to go to their website. If you want to get a bank statement back, a lot of places tell you to go to a website. It's realistically getting harder and harder to say, well, don't use the internet. I mean, it's very hard to be the person that says, no, I want a paper receipt or I want a paper bill. So.
Like when we went out to eat with our mother, and she said that she's not going to use the ATM card. You have to use your Visa card. You
Well,
can't.
she's sitting there going, oh, I'm not going to take the card. Oh, I'm not going to take money on. Like, oh, they'll notice. Like, they'll notice at Walmart. I'm like, they won't. Who's they? The big company? They don't care. They come in. They just want your money. They
Right.
don't
They don't
care
care
if
if you
you.
come in
It's
and
like
just.
going to the place and paying your bill in pennies and making some poor office worker have to count them. You're like, oh, you're sticking it to the man, meaning that guy that's paid minimum wage to be there and put up with your ass because you think you're sticking it to him.
But no, in this case, I don't. He's, well, if you don't want to use it, you don't have to. No, it's not that we don't want to fucking use it. We're paying customers for a fucking service. We don't want our shit stolen. You have to have a search warrant to come in and go through your damn house. But oh, they can just use whatever data I've got and sell it.
Well,
What
it's
was that?
because, see, you're the customer and they're a company and some companies because, they're all about removing restrictions on the companies, but fuck the users.
Yeah,
So.
they say that everything will be better once they loosen restrictions. No, the companies will make more money, the average guy will be fucked more, and that's all there is to it. It's not about your rights. It's not about your rights. It's about the company's rights to fuck you over. That's all it is.
What was that one article we did a long time ago about, I forget if it was a different country or if it was just a state that was considering making the access to internet like a right or something.
Oh, that'd be great.
I think that was the FCC during the whole issue about net neutrality, which
the FCC won't let me be.
Man, I miss the freedoms we used to have.
Just last year and shit.
Just that's that George Carlin bit. Man, I love the freedoms we used to have.
This is
fucking. Yeah, and then we got this new FCC chairman guy in there. I forget what his name is.
The Indian.
He's right. He was all against the net neutrality and protecting people's privacy and stuff, you know.
Oh, Ajit Pai.
Yeah.
That's his name. I had to Google it. I feel like a turd for not remembering it. But I don't remember my own name half the time. Okay. Well, enough being angry about this story. Move on to the next angry story that we'll have.
Yeah, let's have another upbeat story.
Oh, boy. Microsoft says it's already patched Shadow Brokers NSA leaks. Oh, boy.
Four exploits were addressed in March 2017. Update suggests the company may have been tipped off. Yesterday, the mysterious Shadow Brokers posted some hacking tools for Windows that were allegedly stolen from the NSA. All of them were at least a few years old, but exploited flaws in several versions of the operating system to move across networks and infect systems. Early Saturday morning, Microsoft has responded with a blog post saying it has evaluated all of the exploits listed in response to the release. It is surprisingly simple. Most of them have already been fixed. In a statement to Reuters yesterday, Microsoft said that other than our reporters, no individual or organization has contacted us in relation to the materials released by Shadow Brokers. But that may not be the entire truth. For three of the exploits, Microsoft says they didn't affect supported platforms or read any operating system recent enough that it's still receiving security updates. If you're still using them, then you need to upgrade to Windows 7 or newer. For the other seven, the company says all of them are addressed by updates and patches. Notably, the patches reveal these exploits impacted Windows 10 and Windows Server 2016 also. What's particularly curious is that four of the exploits, Eternal Blue, Eternal Champion, Eternal Romance, and Eternal Synergy, were fixed in an update just last month on March 14th because the Shadow Brokers listed what tools they had in January. It seemed like the NSA had to know this release could happen. Despite a long list of acknowledgments for security issues discovered and fixed in the March 2017 update, as the Grug Q points out, there's no name listed for the MS-17-010 patch that fixed these. As far as why, a Microsoft spokesperson tells Engadget that, quote unquote, we may not list an acknowledgement for reasons including reports from employees, requests for non-attribution, or if the finder doesn't follow coordinated vulnerability disclosure. So, I don't know. I guess there was a whole lot about this NSA leak or whatever with this. So, I mean, I'm not too sure. I didn't read the other articles that were about it, but I guess supposedly Microsoft has fixed it or whatever, you know.
Mm-hmm. We fixed it. Wink.
Yeah.
Cool.
Right?
Well, I mean, it'd be stupid to think that they I mean, like they said, these are older, you know, exploits. So it'd be stupid to think they didn't know what the hell was going on. No matter what they do, the NSA is going to find a way to get into your shit.
Yeah.
That's just how they work. Oh yeah, they fixed it. They can't get into. Shut the fuck up. They can get into any fucking thing. So,
They can turn the NSA can turn your an outlet into a microphone.
they could turn your microwave into a fucking microphone.
Yeah.
Oh, fucking what's her name? Damn. I'm sorry. I just,
Wasn't like Prit talking about a lot of NSA stuff lately too?
Who?
That Crit show.
Oh. Well, they've always been, you know, tinfoil hattie.
Yeah, I noticed that.
But you know
Especially that guy
why?
with the sunglasses with the ponytail or whatever.
Yeah. Hutch?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that our last story then?
Yep. Pretty quick.
I don't want my left eyes twitching.
You need some potassium. Eat a banana.
Look at my eye twitching.
I said, I think we're only at an hour and a half. That's pretty quick.
Well, you know, it goes by fast when you don't have to wait for theme music, and
Ba-do-do-do-do.
we don't have to replay all of our stories for Doug.
Yeah.
So
You don't
it's
have to
next
do a whole
story.
long trivia thing.
Yeah. So, what holiday has jack-o'-lanterns?
Right.
Well, thank you guys for coming on. It's been, whoop, I'm froze. Okay. It's been fun floating around in the woods talking to you guys. My secret
Yeah.
location. A bug flew by me. That was cool.
Interesting.
You don't
Yeah, I
say.
don't know what Doug's up to. You sent him an invite, but hey.
Yeah. And I sent him a message with the copy of the
He's
invite
probably
in case he
enjoying
needs.
his pre-Easter time with his family.
Yeah, he doesn't
Yeah.
work at Walmart anymore. He can afford to eat.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, Frank.
Did I say something that no one knows about?
Oh boy.
Did
When are you
I?
gonna get this video monetized? That's all I gotta say.
We don't have enough likes to get monetization.
And we're too vulgar on it anyways.
Yeah, once the little, you know, Fox girl says fuck, it's all over.
I mean, YouTube, a lot of people are actually worried YouTube actually could be done with soon
That's what a lot of
because
the things are. The videos are
you
like,
have
oh,
the
is YouTube over?
Well, you have on one side, you have the advertisers wanting everything family friendly and happy, and then on the other side, you have the content creators are upset over it. So it's like, obviously, YouTube is going to go with their ad revenue, you know.
Yeah, well, the videos I've seen, I've actually seen a few that are like, don't have all your eggs in one basket. Have a Patreon for whatever, and then do, you know, freelance whatever, and do this and that, and make some other fucking money, so that
Yeah.
money you get from the ad revenue isn't your nest egg.
Well, ads haven't been paying that well anyway. It's like, don't expect YouTube to be, paying your rent and ads. So
Right.
even if you were a big popular YouTuber, it's like that's not where most of them get their money from.
I mean, if you're like PewDiePie or whatever, you got tens of millions of subscribers, or you're gonna be pretty rich anyways. You know? They're gonna want to support you. Mean,
All
they'll
right
probably
then.
follow you anywhere, even if you decide to go over to Twitch or something, you know?
Unless you go
Well,
over to like Blip. Remember that?
yeah.
Have you checked out VidMe yet, Frank?
No.
You should check it out. A lot of
I
people are.
signed up for some video thing. When a guy on one of the curators I follow on Steam was streaming some kind of video, I signed up for it, and now I can't remember what it was.
Might have been Rabbit. But, VidMe is, it's a competitor to YouTube, but it's like a lot of people are going there because it's because they want to be uncensored and non-PC, and, yeah, so you're getting a lot of people, posting, like, you know, it's some interesting stuff there.
Right.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, well, are we already done?
I guess so. Guess so, fair princess lady.
Oh, shit. Well, on behalf of myself in the woods and Ben and Ian, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in.
We'll see you on the other side.
Shout out Soko.
Boobs. I don't have the guitar thing to play, so. Boobs.